back for more Beckett, eh? Can't say I blame you. Thanks, for letting me crash here for a bit.
I love the smell of corpses in the morning.
Just taking it all back for more Beckett, eh? Can't say I blame you.
Well, he's the leader of a different gang of raiders. Really tough guy. Sharpened his teeth to points. You know, classy. See, his diary has a lot of, precious, sad little secrets. Stuff you wouldn't want your gang to hear, if you catch my meaning. Well, to impress the Eagles, I sort of stole the diary and stashed it away. So, he's not exactly thrilled with me right now. Thanks. I'll put the word out for a mutual contact while you're out. See if I can arrange for a meeting. And also... Having a good one, I hope. Back for more Beckett, eh?
Always.
You got it. Thanks, for letting me crap back from...
Well, you...
I mean, there's...
Sometimes I think about burning this camp.
Well...
See, his diary has... Well, to impress the Eagles, I... Mind me. Just taking it all in. Good one, I hope. Let me know if I'm in your way.
too much emphasis in the middle there. Okay, let's try. Welcome to the Freak Show!
So, did you find it?
Well,
a bit, sure. I don't know you. Heck, I don't even know if this is actually your place. I just assume it is, because who would lie about this? Anyway, I've got a plan, and it already involves you. But that's exciting to hear, right? So, get ready for it. I've got a buddy named Sage, who joined a stupid cult and got himself swept up into their nonsense. I need you to find him. Get him out of there. And in the meantime, I'll try and get this, diary back to Edwin. Maybe that'll convince him to back us up, hmm? Sound good? Kinda. I mean, look. I haven't met a cult that I thought was good for him yet. He stays with them for a month or so, and then I have to bail him out. All I know is the more he experiments, the more it's messing with his mind. But trust me, you'll see. Sage. He's a violent murderer, a sloppy thief, and used chems until his brain rotted down to almost nothing. Now he sees the world differently than we do. The last time I saw him, I was trying to get out of the Blood Eagles, and he was joining a new cult.
I am going to have a wild.
Well, for a while, he was into a Tato cult. They just spoke to and then ate Tatos. I try not to judge, you know, so moving on. Then he was in a cult that believed we were all living in some kind of terminal program or robotic AI unit. I don't remember anymore. Then he did some Mothman thing. Might still be his jam. Or maybe he's into some other cryptid now. It doesn't matter, honestly. Seriously? Weird. I didn't even pay you anything. You're kind of creeping me out, honestly. Before you go, care for a drink or anything? I might still be. I gotta check my membership cards. But seriously, yeah, it was fun. Rough, but fun. Picked up the wrong sort of attention and got pulled in the wrong direction. Bam, instant Blood Eagle. Worst Blamco product ever. All I have left is a brother. Name's Frankie. But that's something we can talk about some other time.
I hear it's a real trip.
Well, I don't know for sure. There's a cave that he talked about last time I saw him, so I thought you could try there. When I go talk to Edwin's gang, I'm gonna see if they know anything else. Now, I doubt they will, but I may as well ask while I'm there. Well, if you see me again, then everything went swimmingly.
What human flesh tastes like?
Taking it all in.
Welcome!
Thank you.
Strike it big, baby.
All right. You'll have to do. I've got important work that needs to be done. You seem like you're capable enough. I'm Initiate Dodge with the Appalachian chapter of the Brotherhood of Steel. I got word that members from Mariposa are on their way here now. It's critical that I lay the groundwork they need to get a foothold in this region. Are you up for it? Fine, but be quick. I don't have time for a leisurely chinwag. Yeah. Let's see if I can do them justice then. The Appalachian chapter, my chapter, once stood the best chance of bringing back civilization in this damned hellhole. This old husk in front of you is all that's left. Hopefully. The training I have with my chapter's specialized tools can still be of service to the Californian Brotherhood. Now the last one left, far as I know. But the group on their way from California are very much alive. My chapter developed a number of methods for dealing with the threats of this region. It falls on me, and hopefully you, to give them an edge. The deserter came back to make things right. That's all you need to know. And before you go getting all curious to hear Grandpa Vernon's stories, prove to me you're worth my time first. Huh. Well, that doesn't quite make you a true member of the Appalachian chapter. But it took some chops to get that far. I was right to assume you were skilled. You're here already? Damn. I had less time than I thought. If you're really working with them, then it's imperative that you hear me out. About time. I compiled a list of locations the Brotherhood had previously been tracking as enemy hotspots. Every day I'll highlight a location and a mission that can provide the Brotherhood a strategic advantage. I call these daily ops. Head there using your map, and I'll provide instructions. Complete the mission, and there'll be compensation. If you're fast and efficient, I'll even up the reward. If you have any questions about daily ops, ask. Otherwise, hit your map, find the op, and let's take back Appalachia.
On the great day of reckoning, the worthy will become one with the divine light.
Chapter 8. Summoning Rite. On the night of a full moon, gather your fellows and sit around the effigy. Light the pyre, and have all recite the following incantation as one. Oh, bright one, we bid thee, follow this sacred flame with thy ever-watchful eyes. See clear as day this holy fire we burn in your honor like cattle to slaughter. We die for thee. Bid us welcome as we beckon thee with this divine lamp, that we may be blessed by the air underneath thy wings.
The smell of corpses in the morning.
Hmm.
He ran off, right?
Yeah, he does that. But don't worry, he'll find us when he wants to.
But in the meantime, word's come back from Edwin. Turns out recovering his sad little diary isn't gonna be enough, so I thought of another idea.
Find the stolen key to his weapons cache. Now that, and killing the traitor that took it, might be enough to flip him in our direction. Someone from Edwin's gang decided they wanted out. Honestly, Edwin can get pretty weird, so can't say I blame them. But anyway, this idiot thought stealing the key and then blaming it on a rival gang would cause all sorts of problems for Edwin. And they were right. Some nobody who thinks they have it all figured out. I don't even know their name. Hell, I don't even want to know. I just want that key. You do-gooders or something else. You know that, right? I'll be stuck here waiting for Edwin to make peace, so thanks for stepping up. Again. He wasn't interested in meeting with me just yet. He can't trust me. So, he sent someone from his gang, Ronnie. She accepted the journal on his behalf and said he'd meet me here at your place soon. When he feels like it. She said I should wait for him. The weapons cache isn't really the point. This traitor is clearly trying to goad Edwin's gang and a rival gang into a confrontation. Big mistake. Sounds good. And if you happen to find the traitor who stole the key, offing them might be a good idea.
Displaying current stock. Ready to initiate trading. Can I assist you today? ready to exchange items. you stop wasting my time.
Ah, you got the key. Nice. Look at you. You're an animal. You know that? I mean that in a positive way, of course. Anyway, while you were gone, I reached out to Ronnie from Edwin's gang. And they want their key back, but they also want the traitor who stole it dead. The good news is, we finally have a name for this genius. Bronx. Cute, huh? Oh, they, have a bit of a history. Edwin used to walk around with this giant fat cat perched on his shoulder. Right? He loved that cat. I bet you can guess what the Blood Eagles did, right? That's right. They stole his cat, skinned it, and cooked it for dinner. And they sent the bloody pelt back to Edwin in a sack. Classy, right? You got it. I bet there's a stash around there, too. So keep your eye out. You want a drink before you head out? Or what? Not yet. He's, a free spirit. I love him dearly, but, dependability, mindfulness, this plane of existence? Yeah, not his thing. Ooh, I kinda like this. I got the bigger plan, I find the pieces, you execute them. I feel like some sort of mastermind.
Between Rose and me.